In today's video, we will check out some of the basic concepts to explore a data frame, like checking metadata, data type of the variable, elements in the variable. Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. And to understand the concept very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe and hit the bell icon. So let's have a look. We will be using HR data, which would look something like this. And the things which we will learn today are checking rows and columns. And the result would look something like this. Checking the list of columns, which would be like this. And data type of each of the column, which would result something like this. Checking the size of the data frame means elements in the data frame, which would result something like that. Which is nothing, just a multiplication or product of rows and columns. Then we will see how can we check top X rows or N rows, let's say top 10, top 5, top 15, top 20, something like that. How can we show top N rows, and similarly, how can we see top bottom N rows. So without wasting time, let's jump to the Python IDE and check the things one by one. So here I have my HR data created over here, which I did using read CSV method. If you are not aware about this thing, please check out the video for which link is showing at the upper right corner. And we will be mentioning the link in the description section. So let's see first thing. We have this HR data. Now we want to see how many rows and columns does this data frame have. So for that, we're going to use shape function. Nothing, you don't need to do much. Just type the, okay, let me repeat this. Just type the data frame name and use the function. This is called the attribute. So just select that and run it. Here we go. Now here you have the number of rows and then columns. So first element represents to the number of rows and second element represents to the number of columns. So HR data frame contains 14,999 rows and 10 columns. Now, let's see what all are those columns. This tells you the number of columns, but what are the columns which exist in this data frame? How can you check that? For that, you're going to use columns attribute. And here you have the list of all the columns which are available in this particular data frame. All right. Now, let's see. I want to know the data type of each of these 10 columns. How can you know that? How can you do that? So for that, you're going to use D types. You just need to say HR.D types. HR represents to the data frame, which can be anything for you. In my case, I have named it as HR. Like you can see over here, it has mentioned the list of all of the columns in that particular data frame, which are 10 in numbers, and the data type of each of the column. So here, wherever you see object, that means it's a character variable. Wherever you see float, that means it's a decimal variable. This variable contains the value in decimals. Wherever you see int, that means these columns are numeric. These columns have the numeric value. So in our data frame, HR data frame, we have three types of data. One is a string, the other one is decimal and integers. All right. So this is how you can check the data types very easily. Now let's check the elements. How many elements do we have in our data frame? For example, here we saw we have 14,999 rows and 10 columns. So how many elements does it make? It's an element is nothing but the product of rows and columns. So let's see how can we do that. For that, we're just gonna use size attribute, and this will tell you, this will give you the result. So like you can see, it's It's now 149,990. So it's a product of rows and columns. If you have something missing, some any value, this will not be the exact product of rows and columns, right? So any values are eliminated from this count. Now, this is enough of data exploration. We checked number of rows and columns. We checked the list of columns. We checked the data types, right? Now let's see, for each of these things we use separate functions. What if we want to know all of these things in one go? How can we do that? For that we have info option. Info, we're gonna say info, and this function will return you all of the information in one go. Like you can see, number of columns 10, their data types over here, null value, no. None of these columns have any null value. Like it says non-null, non-null, non-null. All right. And here it's here you can see the number of rows and number of rows here. You can see 14,999 number of rows here. And here you can see number of columns as well. So most of the information which we just checked previously using all of these functions, attributes, we just check all of them in using one function, which is info. So that's the very recommended function. You can use this to know all of these things in one go. This is enough exploration of data. Now we want to see the real data. How does this data look like? So for that, this has 14,999 observations, which will be quite huge to display. But if you want, you can specify how many rows you want to see and how many rows you want to see. For example, you say hr.head. So now, like you can see, by default it shows 5. You can specify how many observations do you want to see. For example, I want to see 50 observations. So I would say 50. Like it's becoming difficult for pandas to show all of them over here. So that's why it is showing column one below the other. So this is how you can see. You can also say, I just want to say top 10 rows. Look, here you can see top 10 rows. Similarly, you can say, if you want to see the bottom or maybe last some n number of rows, that you can also do. How can you do that? Using the tell function. Let's say I want to say last 10 rows. So here you go. Here you can see the last 10 rows of each of the columns, in each of the column. All right. Now let's say I want to see bottom 50 rows. So here you have bottom 50 rows. Now there is one thing which you might have noticed. If I want to show all the rows from this particular data frame, it is not showing that. It says dot 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 dot. All right. How can you do that? How can you? What if you want to actually see all of the records? How can you see that? So for that, you can use the option at the beginning. You just say pd dot set options. Like I have done this thing for columns. Similarly, you can do that for rows. Display dot max rows, and here you're gonna say none. All right, now you just select this and run this, and then if you run this, like here you can see it shows all 14,999 observations. I highly recommend you to not try to see all the observation from a data frame. That's not recommended. Always try to use head and tell. Just hope that we clarified the doubts. Just in case if you have any question, do not forget to put that into the comment section. We will definitely try to solve that. And till then, happy learning.